Well, look, just under 1 meter, I found the water table. Oh, this is a bit unnecessary for a single skinned, non-load bearing wall. And the council insist. Well, the building inspector's been, and he just put his head in the hole and said, yeah, that's fine. And I thought he'd be there, the slide rule, big square, a protractor. So this is the meter square hole from just below DPC level for the second support column. Back wall will come out, and this is the meter square or cubed 900 by 900, I should say, foundation for the front support column. As you can see, it's broken through to the outside the existing wall, which we're not allowed to move. Set the levels for the footings, because they all need to be the same level for the steel columns, etc. Didn't want to hire a theodolite light, which would be ideal. I don't know how to use one anyway. Well, I could figure it out. So I've adapted this laser level. So I've got my datum line there, which is 97 above the battery, of course, so I can work down from that. And then I will get my levels using this laser level and just bang some pins in and then mark off the depth there. Simples. Then just to confirm the finished floor level and where the joists actually start on the main building, just take a brick out, easy enough to just drill out all the mortar, since there's far too much sand in it anyway. I could have picked it out with a penknife. And there's the 6x2 floor joist, and that will give me my finished floor level of there, if I just put my finger in, feel the top of it, and then measure it with a tape measure. And then I can calculate, or the manufacturer calculate, the support steels.